Hello everyone! In this video I'm going to show you how to batch process your pictures in Adobe Photoshop. I have here a bunch of pictures that are scanned in color and I want to convert all of them into black and white pictures. So I'm going to fire up Photoshop and in here you can go on File and you have basically two choices. You can use Automate and Batch to process all your pictures or you can just use Scripts Image Processor. Automate will give you some more choices with renaming the pictures and things like this, but I only want to have some black and white. I don't care about the name, so I'm going to use the image processor. In here, we select first our folder. These are already my pictures that are in color right now. And then we're going to select a folder where you want to save our pictures. I create a new one, call this one black and white. Under file type, we're going to keep JPEG as our picture format. And we choose 12 as the highest quality. Now under preferences, we can define our action. In this case, we're going to select custom RGB to grayscale. And now we can click on run and we see what happens. Unfortunately, it's prompting us now to confirm every single picture. So we could do some adjustments and then click on OK. However, we would need to do this for every picture. So I'm going to show you how to avoid this. We go on cancel and abort the whole process. And then we can go to window and open the actions window. In here, you have all the processing actions you can have. And if we take a look at custom RGB to grayscale, you see here this little symbol. If you click on this, you can toggle off the dialog box and it will apply the settings that are currently set in the box. So now we can close this one and we can run the script again on scripts, image processor, and we basically keep all the settings and just click on run. Now you see it's processing all the pictures and we can take a look into the folder and you see here how all the pictures are appearing. Now all our pictures are converted into grayscale. But the really cool thing about the actions window is you can record your own actions for batch processing. So let's try this. We create first a new folder. We call this one My Actions. Click on OK. Now let's open a picture. We're going to take a color picture that we used before. And we can create now our own action. We call this one Black and White. And now we click on record and we basically do what we want to automate for all our pictures. So in this case, I just go into convert the picture into black and white and I just going to use the grayscale for doing so. It gives us a warning that black and white with adjustments might be better, but we ignore this one. And now we can basically hit the stop button and we're done. If we want to apply this now, we go on file. Scripts, image processor, and we do the same thing as before, but this time we change to my actions and we select black and white in here. Let's choose a new destination folder for this action. We call this one black and white 2, create a new folder, and we click on OK and on run again. Now it's doing basically the same thing that it did before, but this time it's a little bit quicker because we converting them directly. So we can take a look and you see again our nice black and white JPEGs. If you want, you can click here to see the InDesign tutorial where we combine all our black and white pictures that we have batch processed now into a single PDF. Alright, I hope you find this tutorial helpful. Until next time, see you!